Hey learner, this is Nilesh Borate. In this video, we have to see some more examples of two-dimensional matrix. So in previous video, we have to see the addition of two matrix. In this video, we have to see the multiplication of two matrices. So first we see that how to multiply the two matrix, okay? So if I consider the two matrix, if we can assume some numbers here, 3, 4, 2, 3, and next one is that 3, 2, 3, 9. If you want to multiply this matrix, then how to multiply these two matrices? So first row is multiply by first column, okay? First number is multiply 3 to this first number 3, and then 4 is multiply by 3. Then we can add both numbers, okay? That is the here. 3 into 3 plus 4 into 3, okay? Then same row multiply by next column. So same here, 3 into 2 plus 4 into 9, okay? Same here, second row. Now second row multiply first column and second column. So 2 into 3 plus 3 into 3, then 2 into 2 plus 3 into 9, okay? So here 9 plus 12, 6 plus 9, 6 plus 36, 4 plus 27, okay? So my answer is that 21, 15, okay? So this is the 42, this is 31. So this is the multiplication of two matrices, okay? So by using the two dimensional matrix, we use the two for loop, okay? A one for rows and the one for column, okay? But if you want to multiply this matrix by using the rows and column, there is a need to declare one more for the multiplication, okay? So going to program section, in previous section, we have to do the addition of two matrices. So I can copy this code by using the matrix multiplication or the multiplication matrix dot C. Okay. So I can copy paste this code. So I can open the multiplication matrix. Okay. So same here, three matrix will be defined X, Y, Z, except numbers from keyboard in matrix 1, in matrix 2. Here I can change some logic, okay? So I can define the one value z of ij is the 0, okay? Then here I can use one more for loop for multiplication. So I can use here the k equal to 0, k is less than column, and k plus plus here z of ij is equal to z of ij plus, I can multiply two matrix, x of ik into y of kj. So this is the logic of multiplication of two matrices. So here I can multiply row wise and here column wise. So this multiplication will be added in Z, and this is repeated till my row and column elements not finishing, okay? And now here you can print matrix 1, 2 and 3, okay? So test this code. I can compile and run. So there is an error, K undeclared. So I can declare the K variable, ij and K. Compile and run. So I can pass here the same numbers. We have to see the example. Okay, so my first number is that the 3, 4, 2, 3. Next number is that the 3, 2, then 3, 9. So see here, the output matrix is the 21, 42, then 15 and the 31. Okay, So this is the multiplication of two matrices. Proceed to next section. So next program is that the transpose of given matrix. Transpose means I can accept one matrix and the outputted matrix is the interchange of the rows and columns of inputted matrix. Okay, so here transpose dot C hash include stdio dot h, then my main method. Inside this I can use one return zero, define one matrix, okay, and for I and j, okay, and for rows and columns, okay. So print here how many rows and columns, then scanf percent d percent d comma and row and column, then print enter elements in matrix 1. Okay, so use here the for loop I equal to 0, I is less than r, then I plus plus, then use another for loop for j equal to 0, j is less than column and j plus plus, then use here one scanf percent d comma and x of ij. Okay, so I can print first my original matrix. So this is my matrix, again by using two for loop. So I can copy this code. Here I can change the printf. Print the matrix. Okay, then here I can use one slash n for going to new line. Okay, now here I can print my outputted matrix, that is the transpose matrix. So I can copy this code. So I can change the title transpose matrix. So here transpose matrix is the interchanging the column and row. So I can change the for loop. Outer for loop is the column wise, inner for loop is the row wise, and my element is also j and I. So my row number is printed in a column number. So original matrix rows number printed in outputted matrix in column number. Okay, so here see the changes that, compile and run. So if three rows and two columns, 1 2 3 4 5 6, you see that this is the three rows and the two columns. So this row is printed in a column 1 2, this row 3 4 is printed in column, and 5 6 printed here 5 6. So transpose matrix is the interchange in between the rows and column element. Okay, so proceed to next section. We have to see to check the given matrix is identity matrix or not. Okay, so I can copy this code identity dot c. Okay, so identity means that I can see one example. If matrix is a 2 by 2, so this is the identity matrix. If matrix is 3 by 3, then 0 1 0 0 0 1, so all the diagonal elements is the 1. So this is called as the identity matrix. Okay, so here first thing is that the order must be same, and next one is that all diagonal elements is the 1 and all non-diagonal elements are the 0. So you can check here the given matrix is identity or not. Okay, so I can convert this program into identity matrix. So first here accept the rows and column. Here I can use one condition, if r is equal to c, then I can use this logic. Otherwise here I can print one error message, invalid order. Okay, so if order is same, then I accept the numbers in matrix 1. Okay, in matrix, just use matrix. Okay, so here I can accept this matrix, I can print here matrix, then here you can check. So I can use here You can see that if my matrix is that 1 0 0 0 1 0 and 0 0 1, so I can assign the index as a rows and column. Okay, so this is my index. So if my diagonal element is, so this is my diagonal element, so this diagonal element is index is the 0 0, this diagonal element index is the 1 1, and this is the 2 2. So in programming section, this is using my I for loop and this is the J for loop. So this logic I can use in a program. If my I and J value will be the same, then here in that position my number will be 1. And if I and J is not equal, then in that position my number will be 0. Okay, so I can use this logic in program. So going to program mode. Okay, so here I can use if and my matrix element is 1, but if it is not equal to 1, okay, so here you can assign one flag variable f1 equal to 1. Okay, so here I can use one f1 variable. So by default f1 is the 0. If my I and J position will be same, then a matrix element will be 1, but if it is not equal to 1, then f1 equal to 1. And next I can check the another condition for non-diagonal elements. If I is not equal to J and x of ij is not equal to 0, then also f1 equal to 1. Okay, so f1 equal to 1 means that this is not an identity matrix. So you can check here after breaking this for loop. If f1 is equal to 0, then print this is identity matrix. Otherwise, print not identity matrix. Okay, so compile this code and run. So how many rows? If I can use 3 row and 4 columns, this is invalid order, okay, because there is need to square matrix. Okay, so if my 3 rows and 3 columns, so 1 0 0 0 1 0 and 0 0 1, so this is my identity matrix. Okay, but if you can use 2 row 2 columns, 1 1 0 1, so this is not identity matrix, but here you can use 1. Okay, so proceed to next section, that last program in this video, symmetric matrix. So what is symmetric matrix? So I can use one matrix here if my number is 1 2 3 2 5 6 3 6 9. Okay, and if I can interchange rows and column, interchange rows and row and column, if this row I can return in a column 1 2 3, then this row I can return in a column 2 5 6, and this row I can return in a column 3 6 9, you can see that both matrix will be the same. If I can interchange the rows and column, and then my matrix will be the same, then this is called as the symmetric matrix. Okay, I can give you one more example. If 1 2 6 3, if I can interchange this, so you can see that 1 2 6 3, so both matrix will not be same, so this is not a symmetric matrix. Okay, so going to program mode, so I can copy this identity matrix program in symmetric. So here copy symmetric.c, symmetric.c. okay, so here I can accept rows and column. In symmetric matrix there is also condition that rows and column will be same, okay, because rows and column must be same here. Then accept number from keyboard, then here you can print original matrix. Okay, then you can see here if if your x of ij means row wise number and this is column wise number x of ji. So in symmetric matrix, row number is same as in column number, but if it is not equal, then here you can assign flag equal to 1. So if flag equal to 0, then this is a symmetric matrix, not symmetric. Symmetric matrix condition is that row number is same as the column number. Okay, so here can compile this code and run. Okay, so two rows, two columns, so 1 2, then 2 1. So here I can, so here this is my typing mistake. X of ij is not equal to x of ji. Okay, so compile this code and run it again. So two row, two columns, so 1 2 2 1. This is my symmetric matrix. You can check here, if I can interchange the rows and column, you will get the same matrix. Again, I can run the 3 by 3. Okay, so 3 row 3 columns. If 1 2 3, then 2 6 9, then 3 9 3. You can see that if I can interchange the rows and column, same matrix will be printed. So this is symmetric matrix. Okay, so test here some invalid case, 2 row and 2 column, 1 2 3 4. So this is not symmetric matrix. Okay, so if you have the any queries, then type on your query in comment box. Likes and subscribe this channel. See you on next video. Thank you.